Hey folks, this is Daryl Cagle. Today I'm going to be drawing the new half-price generic Mylan EpiPen, which has been so much in the news yesterday. You know, they raised the price on their EpiPen, which is for people who have terrible anaphylactic shock allergy problems, like to peanuts that puts them into a coma or something. So a very necessary thing. Used to cost $100, now it costs $600. And that's kind of price gouging, you know, and we're seeing that a lot from pharmaceutical companies now, these evil, greedy bastards who just do whatever they can get away with. And, you know, it's a political issue because people want to regulate these greedy bastards and perhaps do a bit to facilitate some competition among these guys who enjoy little monopolies. So, today's cartoon is going to be, this is what I did on my little post-it note. So here's the victim, and he or she, probably she, I think, is going to have this giant screw. Maybe it should be a he so that there's no sexism involved with the screw. I guess I probably should do that. One of the problems that editorial cartoonists have we're always criticized for drawing too many white men and for editorial cartoonists themselves being too many white men. But the problem that we face is that if you draw a woman in a cartoon instead of the generic white guy or a minority instead of the generic white guy in a cartoon like this where I just have a victim who could be anybody, then the question becomes, why is it a woman? And why is it the black guy? Or why is this a Latino? Because you're just not used to seeing them in particular in editorial cartoons as a generic figure. So when you draw them, as we probably should equitably mix a bunch of different people into our generic characters. But the reason you don't is you don't want to draw that question of why are you drawing this guy in particular. And so it's a catch-22. I have no good solution for it. So I think I'll just draw a generic white guy. Because drawing a screw through a woman raises other issues that I don't want to deal with. And drawing a minority raises other issues. As why is it a minority? I don't have good answers to these things, so I continue drawing generic white guys. So, sorry about that, folks. Do what you gotta do. Please, if you haven't followed me before, I appreciate a follow. And please comment. I appreciate the comments. So, Mylan, I'm going to do a little circle R because that's kind of funny. So we'll draw this guy standing like this. Give him a lot of torso because I need space for that screw. It could be a Phillips head. Then people are going to say, why did you draw a Phillips head? Do you have something to against Phillips heads? Is this guy named Phillips? Okay, he's basically suffering here because this thing is too expensive. And it's a giant screw going through his torso. Plenty of reason to look disturbed. Okay, so here is the base of the screw. And we'll make the screw go this way.
not quite perpendicular there. Fix that. So then I'm going to have... Maybe I should look at screws. Excuse me, I'm going to do a quick Google Images search on screws. Well, lots of good looking screws here. This is what I'm looking at. They are a bit more narrow, and those screw ridges are a little bit shorter than I expected. Phillips heads. They like the Phillips heads on Google. Notice that? Oh, I wonder why. Are they making some comment about Phillips heads? All right. Well, maybe I should do a Phillips head. I don't know. It's not like you folks comment. So let's go back to this. Now that you know what I'm looking at, so there's no mystery. And I'm just going to add details. Wrinkles in the pants. Gotta do the shoes. I like having a flat floor that people stand on rather than looking down at the ground in some kind of a perspective view. Cartoons are pretty simple things. So, I know other cartoonists do lots of funky perspective, but not me. I like to have kind of consistent point of view in the way that I draw. All right, that's going to enter his torso around here, and he's going to have some wrinkly cloth issues going on. Bit of a belt. His shirt hang out a little bit, because it is, you know, just screwing in through his torso. That's unpleasant stuff, you know, screwing through your torso. All you silent folks, Twitch says I'm offline. Wonder why that is. That's why you folks are silent. Maybe I should start this up again. Okay, let's see if that gets us going again. I just did a streaming restart. See if it works. Yeah, it looks like it's working. It says it's offline, but it looks like it's working. All right, let's see if we can get you folks back. Sorry about all the tech problems. Today I've got to blame OBS rather than Twitch. Okay, he's got a chin. More of a nose that way. Move his hair back a little bit.
this. When you draw some kind of circular thing, it is often easier to scribe it into a rectangle. I think I will do the Phillips head. To think a little bit about whether I want a Phillips head. I'm not entirely sure. This could be a little bit bigger. The head of the screw. Well, no. They're kind of consistent on what size they are, aren't they? So if I don't do a Phillips head, if I do a standard one thing head, that goes all the way to the edge, doesn't it? Close to the edge. I think. Kinda, maybe. Alright, he needs more pain expression in his fingers. We'll get that there. We have a little bit there, too. Okay, screw. I think I've got that. He's not going to have any blood going on. Give him some squeens. And he needs real teeth. Futz with that a little bit more. Okay, here is an arrow. This arrow, it says, then I'm gonna be another arrow down here. Goes like that. And this arrow says, the new. Price generic Mylan. You want to put their name in there because you want them to suffer for their greed by some bad press. here it will say same as the old EpiPen. So the point is, he's still screwed even at half the price. That's the gag. Still screwed at half the price. Okay, let's see if I can improve this a bit. This arrow could be two lines instead of one. And that would look better. So, should point there. I might move this arrow back a little bit yet. Okay, a little bit of background texture. Which can come down that way. Could come around this way too. Very editorial cartoonist thing to do, the swooping crosshatchy background texture. This needs to be a little tighter. And same as the old EpiPen, I think that's fine. And it's a little funny that you have to turn it on its side to read it. And it's also two lines. This could be a little bit wider. Move that to there. All right. I think that works. Let's work on this guy. Maybe a bunch of crosshatch in him is fun. Put a lot of crosshatch into people. It has that kind of a flavor of an old underground comics cartoon. Have a little bit of correct teeth going on with the guy. And he looks kind of troubled. Ear can be whatever shape works. People have their bee allergies. They keep these things all the time. You think of them as something kids need. Parents need to keep them on hand because you never know what the kids are going to do. Eat a peanut, get stung by a bee. And they're expensive things. I don't think I like his teeth. reconsider his teeth.
I need a better distressed mouth shape, so let's go with... something not as wide. I give him a little more chin. There, that looks equally troubled, but doesn't have to take up as much height, which is good. Mouth is better. Okay. So there's his arm. His shirt has to have these wrinkles, and the screw enters here. I kind of like the shirt tail being out. That's kind of a cute detail, so we'll keep that. If I can improve his hand a little bit. It's a little bit better. Not a lot better. But a little bit better. Okay, this hand can be riding on his knee. That gives a reason to have it partially obscured. That's not quite as awkward. Yes, I think about those things. Excuse me. Yeah, I need a sneeze cough button. All right. Now, the screw. Probably still have to think about that a little bit. Single screw? It ends just before the end, doesn't it? Okay. That is going to have to
move that way, isn't it? In order to match up with being perpendicular. It's going to have to move down that way just a bit. This is going to have to move up just a little bit that way. These go like that. Okay, so that has to move. Give him some lines showing that he's kind of upset in this direction. Got some width going over here, so they kind of pushed back into that corner. It's kind of funny. Do you notice on my last cartoon, the Hillary Foundation cartoon, I signed it twice to DarylCagle.com. I didn't even notice it. And of course, you guys, it's not like you pipe up to tell me this stuff. You've got silent people. So I put my signature in there twice. Crazy. Could be sweat. All right, I think I've got this. That has to move. Don't forget. Okay, now the first thing I'm going to do when I draw this is the lettering. So let's grab a piece of paper here. What have I got? Draw with Duraline paper, as anyone who watches regularly knows, because it's got a lovely texture, allows me to use hard pencils and make my pencil look like ink, and it makes a nice original, and it's very durable plastic. They say it will last till the end of time. Okay, let's start with the lettering and fit the arrows around the lettering. Condense it a little bit and use more lowercase. New can be all caps.
Some people complain about me dropping my head down, going out of the camera view. They do, they email me and complain. The new, let's give it a hyphen. Half price generic. That looks bad. Not pleased with my GE, so we'll clean those up. Another nice thing about this Duraline paper is how nicely it erases. As a guy who erases a lot, I think it needs a lowercase e. Generic.
half-price generic Mylan EpiPen. Hard for me to talk when I do lettering, because then I spell things wrong. Use this wrong part of my brain. See if I want a broken back end of the arrow. Maybe I do and maybe I don't. So, no comments from you folks, huh? Worth signing into Twitch just to be able to comment. Stretch this lettering around a little bit because it is not quite perfect. That could come a little bit that way, that could go a little bit that way. So I may do that. That'll be for Photoshop. Let's do same as the old pen first as well. So you see it's the same as the old EpiPen, both in the respect that it is the same gizmo, and in the respect that he's getting screwed just as much by a $300 EpiPen as by a $600 EpiPen. Same as the old EpiPen. Kind of funny to have it run sideways. Move old a little bit that way. So So let's get an arrow here. Okay. Now I think I'll move this just a little bit to make this screw a little bit better position. Okay. That's a little bit better. Draw the perspective on the screw now. So these things are not really as tall as they might seem. I guess drawing screw in perspective kind of uses the same talking part of my brain as does lettering. Okay, is that looking good? That look like a screw? Okay, I think that's kind of as much detail as I need in a cartoon. I might move this arrow back just a skosh. I can do that in pencil, can't I? Let's do that easier here than in Photoshop. There have been quite a few EpiPen cartoons. There have probably been some screws. But I don't think there are any right now about the generic half-price one. They're just general screw-over cartoons. Okay. Over here on my right, you see this little bit of red paper. That is my sandpaper that I use to give me a chisel point on the pencil that I am pleased with from time to time. Knuckle and sense of bones being inside this hand, which is in a position to express stress. This fella is under stress. It's nice being able to draw an everyman that doesn't have to be a caricature. All I need to be concerned with is expression and position and flow, which very often I compromise in order to get a likeness. Drawing on this for almost an hour. I guess that's pretty predictable. is bicuspid. There's the first molar. Bicuspid, first molar on the bottom, second molar. Yes, I think about what his teeth should look like. Okay. So if I don't get more comments out of you Twitch people, I might just switch to YouTube. Boy, my glass likes to disappear, huh? Water glass. I think if you were getting a giant screw in your torso, that the shirt would have lots of this twisty wrinkles. Okay. Okay, shoes. going back this way too. All right, other shoe. Okay, I'm going to move the head of the screw so that it looks right with the perspective here. So, where does that go? Let's see. That goes that way. Does that look right? I think it does not. I'm not pleased with that. Let's try something else. Maybe it needs to be Phillips head. Maybe Google is right, and all of these little screws just make more sense if you look at them as a Phillips head. So I think I'll give a Phillips head a try. Phillips head. Yeah, that long strip just looked like it might have been a reflection or something, or it's just something wrong. So Phillips head is going to be like that. And that. Phillips head. Do I like that? I don't know. That needs to come down just a skosh, doesn't it, on this side? Pain in the butt drawing things that have perspective. Alright, does that look like a screw? Maybe all I do on it to get it to look like a screw. Ground. Okay. Let's give him some squeens and some crosshatch. Okay, let's have some background crosshatch. Well, I could have a little more contrast on this background, huh? Let's do that. Better. A little more sharpen and a little less brightness, a little more contrast. Yeah, it's a little bit better. You can see that a little more clearly now. Light changes throughout the day. Okay. I can go light on this background stuff. I'm getting just about finished with this. In another few minutes, I'm going to do the color. So, if you're watching, get ready for video number 2, which will be the color version of this. Getting screwed by the EpiPen. New half-price EpiPen, same as the old EpiPen. Alright, I think I'm done here. I could keep fiddling with it obsessively if I had to, but I think I'm done. Alright, I'm going to wrap this up. This is the end of part 1. And part 2 will be coloring this after I've scanned it in. So I'm going to scan it in and color it. And that will be video 2. So, thank you folks for joining me today. That marks the end of our exciting video. And I will see you in part 2.